And welcome back to The Factor Uncensored. Money is definitely the motive tonight. Tuesday is tax filing day. And if you're rushing to get your business in order, don't stress out too much. Certified public accountant Ed Gardner joins us here on a Monday. You're usually here on a Tuesday, but we needed you. It's an emergency, Ed. So first of all, if you don't file tomorrow, what happens? You don't do anything.
If you don't do anything, you could be assessed a penalty of 5% a month up to an extra 25%. And then, of course, on anything that you owe the IRS, you're going to pay penalties and interest on the unpaid balance until you pay your tax bill.
Wow. Now, if you can't file tomorrow, what are your options?
Well, the biggest thing is file an extension. Now, it's important to know it's an extension of time to file, not to pay. Mm-hmm. So at least file your extension. And if you think you're going to owe, Isaiah, then you should send some money in with it.
Okay. Got it. Now, any tax tips, anything we're missing this tax season that we should be paying particular attention to, Ed?
Well, if someone is going to put into an IRA, they have to do it by tomorrow. Because even with an extension, they can't deduct an IRA for last year. If they put it in afterwards, it would be for the following year.
Mm-hmm. Now, what about us regular-ass people, Ed? Regular people ain't talking about IRAs just about now. So any changes, any differences in the tax law and code that would affect the average person that we need to remember tomorrow?
Well, nothing other than if you are self-employed, not only do you need to worry about filing an extension tomorrow, but you need to make your first quarterly estimated tax payment for the 2023 year.
Mm-hmm. So even if you're filing, like you said, extension four, as a worker or someone who is self-employed, you need to pay those taxes or at least something.
Right. And, of course, you can go online to the IRS and file your extension. You also can pay the IRS online, or you can mail in the extension to the IRS and send a check with it.
Now, when we talk about an extension, how much time does that give you?
It gives you up to October 15th to file your tax return.
Okay, got it. And is the IRS back up to snuff? Obviously, they had some problems during COVID, had problems before COVID. Are they up to staff? Are they ready for this day? Will they be inundated? What do you know?
They've gotten better, Isaiah, because back in March of 20, they furloughed about 40% of their workforce. Mm-hmm. And they're still not quite up to their full workforce. But they are catching up, and they're doing everything possible to try to get old tax returns processed. There's still returns from previous years that haven't been filed handled.
And for those who are saying, I hope they don't ever get back up to full staff, have we seen any, allocations from the federal government to increase their numbers, to do more, have more IRS workers, agents that are out there?
Well, under the act that they had last year, they're hiring 87,000 new IRS agents. But with that, about 5,000 were put on the telephone to help answer questions to the consumer, because they weren't answering less than 10% of the phone calls that people were making. And then, of course, there are a lot of agents that will be retiring in the next 2 to 5 years, so there's agents there to replace it, the current personnel that they have.
All right. Ed Gardner, always good to see you here on The Factor Uncensored, and on a Monday night, too.